Hey, this is Jessica McBride from Tech Savvy Assistant. Today we're going to be covering how to use ChatGPT to streamline our workflows, as well as the addition of another very cool AI program. I hope that you've come along with me and see how we can use AI to be more efficient and productive in our everyday workflows. A really great way to use ChatGPT is, say you got asked to create an onboarding plan. I know for me, when that happened, I didn't really know what to do or where to go. And ChatGPT did not exist at that point or wasn't available to the public. So I went to Google and I found a bunch of different onboarding documents and I kind of pieced them together. And I said, this is what I think that an onboarding document looks like. But using ChatGPT, we can ask it to create a 30, 60, and 90-day onboarding plan for a new employee. This is going to be a general plan for all employees. They're going to need to attend a work safety meeting. Sexual harassment, they're going to meet all of leadership the first week, and then they should have a regular check-in with their managers. Now, I'm using ChatGPT 3.5, so this is the base model that is available to anyone for free. It is not the paid version. Right, and now it's going to give us an onboarding plan for the new employee. And it's going to break out day by day, week by week, what we should be having the new employee look at doing to make sure that they get onboarded properly. Because we want to make sure that customers and employees are onboarded because that's going to set them up for success. So a lot of the stuff is, yeah, things that you would absolutely think about on your own, but a lot of it is really easy to miss. I know that when I was building the onboarding plan, it just we had to iterate on it several times to really capture everything that we wanted it to capture. And having ChatGPT to just do a first draft for you is really incredible. It's going to save you so much time. It's just going to be able, you're just going to copy and paste this into your word processor and go from there and just build yourself this like very cohesive, perfect onboarding document. It's going to impress everybody you work with, and they're going to be like, wow, you're so cool to create such an amazing onboarding plan. If only, right? And so, yeah, it's still going. It's still giving week by week. And I also, I wanted it to make sure that it did include the regular check-ins so that they are regularly talking to their manager. We love open communication. And then it's going to provide you this in-depth onboarding checklist. That way, every time that you onboard an employee, you have this little checklist to go through and you're making sure that you're ticking all of your boxes so that at the end of their onboarding plan, you can say, yeah, I did my part. I did what I was supposed to do here. All right. Next, we're going to use ChatGPT to create a meeting agenda. So I know that this is something that I see happen a lot, is we're expected to know how to do meeting agendas and templates and notes and all of these different formats that like don't make any sense to me. So we're going to ask it to create a format for company-wide meeting agenda for a quarterly offsite. And very, very quickly, it's going to present us with an outline of how we could do that. Okay. Then say we want to send this out to our company. We want to make sure that we're letting them know. So we're going to say, create a email. We're just going to go ahead and ask them to announce this kickoff and create a compelling title for it. So now it is writing the email that you can then send out. Right, let's use it to plan this event. Okay, so we're going to ask it to create some ideas around this theme. And here are some ideas. I would hate to do all of them, but I think that a lot of people would enjoy them. I shouldn't say that I would hate all of them. Escape room could be fun. Innovation hackathon. These aren't bad ideas. So I'm going to go ahead and continue to build on this a little bit. So I want to create like fun themed foods, right? So based on the theme, create a menu and make sure that it is kosher. Menu item should be themed. See, okay, and this is one of those things where my interpretation of what it should be kosher and what that, it completely misunderstood, right? So we're going to go back and we're going to actually say, okay, let's look at what I said. Based on the theme, create a menu, make sure it is kosher. Menu item should be themed. Theme the menu. Ensure menu items are kosher. Not themed kosher. Let's see if it gets it right this time. There we go. Techno tacos. Bite-sized bellinis. So this is really adorable. I would definitely want to enjoy this. And then we're going to see what else could we do that might, you know, be useful to do to plan this event. Is let's write a thank you email to our vendors. It's going to write a thank you email. Suggest say that you are wanting to look for sponsors. So let's find sponsors for our event. Or I guess let's write a communication to sponsors. Let's shoot for the stars, right? So it's going to help you write a compelling sponsor request. So those are just a few different ways that we could use ChatGPT, and this is just 3.5, to create different plans, help it create text communication, and provide a way to present yourself a little bit more professionally than like your first instinct would be to be. And I'm someone who uses the term professionally loosely, but I do understand that we all have to show up a certain way at work, unfortunately. So this is a really handy way to kind of hit the right notes. The last program we're going to talk about in our last little foray into artificial intelligence is a program called EA Buddy. EA Buddy was designed for executive assistants in mind, and it's a really great tool for all admin professionals that have a lot of scheduling to do. I use it for myself personally in my own business because it's such a great tool. I have a lot of meetings that end up being in Australian time zones. One of my peers that we do a podcast together is in Sydney, Australia, and I'm constantly having to open up EA Buddy to see again, like, what are the times that actually work for both of us. So as you can see here in the time zone converter, I have put in Toronto, Canada, which is my time zone, Sydney, Australia, which is hers. We can see now that it's most likely just going to be yellow or green. So a lot of times when we meet, it's at like 7 or 8 my time and 9, 10 in the morning hers. And those are really the only the times that kind of work for us. So what I can do though, is I can say, okay, I would like to meet at 7 p.m. or 8 p.m. And it's going to populate a little template on the side. Additionally, I could then create a meeting poll. I'll move my face so you can see. It shows the different meeting times that could possibly work if we do a 30-minute meeting. Additionally, it's going to pull up my calendar, and I'll show you if I needed to be able to give meeting times for tomorrow, I would hit share availability. And then I can go in and I can select the time slots that work for me tomorrow, or you know, 2 days from now. And it's going to create a template on the side that I can then copy and paste and send over. It's also, you can gather availability. So you can send this link and say, if we want to meet on the 22nd, I can meet anytime between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. And it's going to create this link. At the same time, it's tracking these in your meeting tracker so that you're able to go in and say, okay, when did I put holds on? So I don't lose sight of these. And then say things don't work out, you would just delete the meeting. I think EA Buddy for me is really most valuable in the sense of that I cannot keep track of the meetings that I have at the moment. And a lot of times I'll be looking at my calendar and I'll be going back and forth to my emails and I will forget the time that I had said before I've even gotten there. So using EA Buddy saves me a lot of trouble because I can just integrate or just use the template. So eabuddy.com, really cool program. Check it out.